In this video, we will explore a couple of ways to make a spinning top without a lathe. I began by designing the vector templates of my top. Next, I created a new easel project. Easel is the online software my 3D carver uses. I imported my template as an SVG file. I set the machine to cut outside the lines. I chose a cutting bit and ran a simulation to see how the machine is planning to carve. For this project, I used 5mm plywood. It is important for the material to be secure and flat, so I screwed an extra clamp in place. I like to home the machine manually. And finally, I started carving. Using a chisel, I cut the tabs off. The first one had pretty loose joints, so I readjusted my design and started a new 3D carving session. The second top came out better, but it was still loose. It was also proof that the top works. As you can see, these joints have gaps, and this area is about 1mm larger. Again, I readjusted my design for the last time. And that was it. Some sanding after removing the tabs. I made a custom file using a popsicle stick, double-sided tape and sandpaper. Although this was not necessary, I glued all the parts together. And I used my vise as a clamp. Now, if you don't have a CNC, you can go to my Inventables project page, select the spinning top, and open the easel file. Here, you can download the vector SVG files. And this is a good reason for you to create an easel account even if you don't have a CNC yet. After you print out the templates, you can use spray adhesive to glue them on the plywood. Next, drill your saw blades entry holes. To cut the templates, you can use the scroll saw or a fret saw. For the fret saw, you can make this tool. Which you can screw on your bench. If you use the bandsaw for the outer lines, be extra careful because that's a really small piece. A set of small files can also prove really handy here. Next, I'm gonna use a V-carving bit to carve different designs for my top's top. Now I switch to this bit to cut the caps off. I painted my caps with latex paint. I like it because it dries really fast, doesn't smell bad, and it is water-based. You can speed up the drying process with the heat gun. Some designs require masking. It is a good idea to paint darker colors over lighter ones. To remove the excess paint, I will sand with 100 grit. I made one top and I will test the rest of the caps on this one. I like the different animations produced by the caps. I definitely like the spirals most. You can also experiment by animating colors. Yellow and red will produce an orange effect. As you can see, the top can spin for a really long time. The project turned out nice. Tops are always fun to make and play with. The animations can give you vertigo, but I love them. I hope you enjoyed this project as much as I did. I also hope that you'll make some of these tops yourselves. At this point, I want to thank Inventables for sponsoring this project. You will find their links in the description of the video. But that was it. See you soon with a new project video.